सभी लोगों को मेरा नमस्कार। ज्योति विद्यापीठ की इस मुहिम में, जिसमें कि लॉकडाउन के दौरान भी हमारी शिक्षा व्यवस्था सुचारू रूप से चलती रहे, इस हेतु जो ये ऑनलाइन ई क्लासेस शुरू की गई हैं वीडियो लेक्चर्स के रूप में, इसमें आपका स्वागत है। मैं JVN डॉक्टर अनिल कुमार वंगानी, HOD डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ रिपर्ट्री, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, आज आपका जो है एक लेक्चर लेने जा रहा हूँ। एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ द लेक्चर इज द हॉट एंड चिली रेमेडीज। स्पेशली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कैंट्स रिपर्ट्री, इन विच इन द प्रीफेस यू कैन सी दैट डॉक्टर गिब्सन मिलर्स हॉट एंड कोल्ड रेमेडीज हैव बीन गिवन। So we have extracted it from Dr. Kent's work, the remedies which are predominantly chilly, that is aggravated by cold. A few of them I will name, for example, agaricus, agnus, alumina silicata, R. sulflavus, arsenic, beretta carb, belladonna, calcarea ars, calcarea fos, कैप्सिकम, कार्बोवेज, कोलोफाइलम, कॉस्टिकम, चाइना, डलकमारा, यूफ्रेशिया फेरम, ग्रेफाइटिस, हिपार, हाइपेरिकम। सो हेयर यू कैन सी दैट द रेमेडीज विच आर वेरी मच चिली, दे आर गिवन एज फर्स्ट ग्रेड, दैट इज द कैपिटल फॉन्ट, विच आर सेकेंड ग्रेड लिटल लेस चिली देन द टॉप मोस्ट, they are given in italic, and the remedies which are which are less chilly than the first two grades, they are given as simple Roman. Here you can see cardus. The further listing of chilly medicines like Caliars, Calicarb, मैग्नीशियम कार, मैग्नीशियम फॉस, मॉस्कस, नेट्रमार्स, नेट्रम कार्ब, नाइट्रिक एसिड, नक्स वोमिका, फॉस्फोरस, सोराइनम, पायरोजेनियम, रस्टॉक्स, व्यूमैक्स, सेबेडिला, स्ट्रॉन्शियम एटसेट्रा। सो दैट फॉर ऑल द चिली रेमेडीज वी आर हैविंग इन होम्योपैथी। रेमेडीज विच आर प्रेडोमिनेंटली hot, that means aggravated by heat. A few of them I will name, like Aesculus hippocastrinum, Argentum nitricum, Apis mellifica, Auromet, Fluoric acid, Caliiodum, Iodum, Calisulfuricum, Natramur, Lycopodium, Natrum sulfuricum, Platina, Pulsatilla, Sabina, Sickle, sulfur iode, Vespa, etc. Now we can have certain remedies which are sensitive to both extremes of temperature. You call it ambithermal. So I will name a certain remedies under this group, like Mercurius, Ipecac, Natrum carbonicum, and Cinnabaris. You know, Antim crude is aggravated by both heat and cold, aggravated by overheating and by the radiating heat, though many symptoms are ameliorated by heat also. Mercurius in chronic troubles is aggravated by cold, whereas in acute, it is aggravated by heat. So, how to use the knowledge of thermals about these remedies in our clinical practice? For that, we have to discuss certain case studies. So the first case we are going to discuss is of a lady, 52 years of age, who has been a heavy tea drinker for last 20 years, had more pain and discomfort in stomach with flatulence immediately after eating, gradually got better till next meal. much rumbling in abdomen is there. Appetite is poor. Bowels are fairly regular. The flushes of heat with sweating, which relieves her. Now you can compare it with her age, 52, and she is having flushes of heat. That means it is climacteric flushing. So will you call it a hot patient or a chilly? You have to decide. On further inquiry, she was found to be very chilly. So these flushes are not known as, or will not make the patient hot. The patient is basically chilly, and the flushing is due to climacteric ailment. The generals of this patient, that the patient is very chilly, worse in springs, worse before and during thunderstorm. Patient is very sensitive, readily offended, sensitive mentally, I want to say. She is readily offended. Aasani se bura maan jaati hai. Startled easily with least noise. Thodi si awaaz se chonk uthti hai. Chilly patient, used as eliminating symptom in this case. Only chilly remedies are given in the following list. So the chief remedies running through the case are arsenic, calcarea, causticum, natrum carb, nux vomica, phosphorus, rustox, sepia. Now, giving different rubrics their value, the capital is given three marks, italic 2 marks, and ordinary given 1 mark. We find that arsenic appears 8 times with the value of 16. So, covering 8 symptoms, having 16 points. Calcarea covering 8 symptoms, having 14 points. Causticum, 7 symptoms, 13 points. Natrum carb, 6 symptoms, 9 points. Nux vomica, 6 symptoms, 9 points. Phosphorus, 10 symptoms, 18 points. Rustox, 7 symptoms, 12 points. Sepia, 6 symptoms, 11 points. So the remedies are here arranged alphabetically, out of which you can see phosphorus is carrying highest marks and highest coverage of symptoms too. The constitution of the patient suggests that either she is arsenic or phosphorus. We have thus come to these two remedies by only considering the general symptom of the patient. The pain in stomach was better by hot drinks. Even wine, which suits her generally, had to be given up owing to its coldness. And as phosphorus patient craves cold drinks, even ice, in gastric troubles, now we are left only with one option, and that is arsenic. So in the case, we have given arsenicum album 30, 3 doses at 6 hour interval. The pain was ameliorated in this case after giving these doses of arsenicum in 30 potency within a few days. And in a few weeks, she was almost well, being much less excitable anymore. Now this case shows the importance of generals in their order: mental, climatic, desire and aversion in food, all of which must be markedly present to be of any value. Now we will discuss another case, a lady of 35 years. She was sleepless since 20 years of age. She is now 35 years. That means she's been sleepless, having sleeplessness for last 15 years. This was brought on by excessive musical study, never taken any sleeping drugs. She lies quite wide awake at night, brain is active all the time, especially after lights are out. So jaise hi raat ko lights band kiye jaate hain, switch off kiye jaate hain, uska brain hyperactive ho jata hai. Aur ye aisa kab se ho raha hai? Jab se usne excessive musical study ki hai, bahut zyada music ko suna hai. प्रोफेशनल बनने के लिए बहुत ज्यादा म्यूजिक को सुना उसने. ऑफन केप्ट अवेक बाय परसिस्टेंट ट्यून्स, उसके दिमाग में कोई ना कोई धुनें गूंजती ही रहती हैं. हार्डली एवर फॉल्स एस्लीप फॉर 3 आवर्स आफ्टर गोइंग टू बेड, मतलब 3 घंटे तक भी उसको नींद नहीं आती लेटने के बाद. रेडिली वेकेंड बाय लीस्ट ग्लीम ऑफ लाइट, थोड़ी बहुत आ भी जाती है तो थोड़ा सा भी लाइट का चकाचौंध उत्पन्न हुए कहीं भी तो वह उठ बैठती है. इवन इफ ड्राउजी बिकम स्लीपलेस इमिडिएटली ऑन गेटिंग इन टू बेड, बहुत ज्यादा नींद आ रही है, सोने की कोशिश करती है, नींद नहीं आती है. हमेशा ड्रीम्स आएंगे, हल्की सी भी नींद आएगी ड्रीम्स आएंगे, और डरावने टाइप के सपने आते हैं. General health has been good. Throat is painless with hoarseness. All colds fly here. That means all colds settle in the throat and she's having hoarseness. Stomach. The appetite is so good, but she's averse to fats and milk and craves ice and cold food. Emptiness without hunger soon after getting into bed, which might prevent sleep. सोने के तुरंत बाद उसको emptiness feeling होती है और भूख लगती है. Better by eating. Emptiness at 11 a.m. in the morning. Malarial parasite test. It's normal. Mental. Very excitable to music. Irritable. Impatient. Discontented. Fear in a crowd. Being hemmed in. Fire. Suffocation. Indifferent to people, especially relatives. Depressed easily. So she's a very sensitive kind of patient who's very easily excitable, especially to the music. She's very sensitive to music. She's impatient. She's indifferent. Easily get depressed. Easily feel suffocation. She's fear of crowd. These are all her mental condition. Now the patient is chilly. He hates cold and she's worse in thunderstorms. Chili here is used as an eliminating symptom to cut all the warm remedies as we have shown in the following list. Indifference relations, the remedies were Helleborus, Hippar, Natrum Carb, Phosphorus, Sepia. Here's crowd in, the main remedies were Aurum, Baryta, Calcarea, Causticum, Graphitis, Hippar, Calias, Calibichrome, Natrum Ars, Nux Vomica, Phosphorus, Rustchop. Fierce suffocation. The main medicines were phosphorus, stramonium. Fierce fire. The medicine was Euprum, one and single. Then worse or aggravates during thunderstorm. Main remedies were agaricus, calibichrome, natrum carb, sorinum, rhododendron, sepia. Averse to fats. The main medicines were arsenicum, carbo animalis, China, Ginomars, Cyclamen, Colchicum, Hippar, Petroleum, Sepia, etc. Also phosphorus you can see here. Aversion to milk. The main medicines were Calcarea, Quercum, Ignatia, Lactiflorettum, Natrum Carbonicum, Nux Vomica, Sepia, etc. Desire for cold food. The main medicines under this rubric are Phosphorus, Thalassia. Phosphorus in the highest field. Desires for eyes. It's Calcarea and phosphorus in the highest field. Emptiness feeling 11 a.m. It's Alumina, Natrum Carb, Phosphorus, Sepia, Zinc. Emptiness without thirst or hunger. Emptiness without hunger. The medicines are Alumina, Agaricus, Baryta Carb, Muriatic Acid, Phosphorus, Rustchop, Salicylic Acid, Sulfuricum. Sleeplessness after going to bed. The main medicines are Borax, Metcalf, Phosphorus. Some idea or tune always repeated in mind. The medicines are Calcarea, Coffea, Graphitis. Hoarseness, painless. The main medicines for this rubric are Calcarea, Carbovegi, Causticum and Phosphorus. So the repertorization results are Calcarea containing 6 rubrics having 11 marks, Natrum Carb 6 rubrics 10 marks, Phosphorus 12 rubrics 24 marks, and the Sepia 5 rubrics 10 marks. You can see Phosphorus carrying highest marks and the highest rubric coverage. So the larger rubrics such as sensitive to noise, impatience, they are left out as all the competing med remedies are there in them. They were of no use. Phosphorus not only was best indicated, but it has the important peculiar symptoms in difference to relations. All the fears like, but except fire. And the marked craving for ice was there in phosphorus. So on June 16, she got the dose of phosphorus 10N. 3 doses were given 6 hours apart. on July 4th, almost in 22 days, she writes, she has been sleeping better and have been much quieter mentally at night. No more medicine was given on this reporting. Then on July 27th, again in near about 23 days, where she says that she's very much better generally, sleeping better, even with worrying times, she can sleep now, not half so tired as usual, no emptiness even at 11 a.m. now, no restless feeling mentally at night, no persistent tunes or thoughts, not dreaming so much now, extraordinary better she is. So no more medicine was required. The patient was cured totally. Now, we are going to discuss the third case in this regard to know how to use hot and chilly remedies. Here, there's a case of a male who is 28 years of age and has complaints of pain and distension in abdomen for last 3 years, especially 6 a.m. to 4 p.m. and feels like bubble inside abdomen, been taking soda or soda bicarb all the time, means repeatedly taking soda bicarb, distension not for some time after eating. मतलब खाने के थोड़ी देर तक तो नहीं होता, उसके बाद distension उसको शुरू हो जाता है. Better by escaping flutters, which is offensive. Better by hot drink. Sleeps well till he is wakened at 6 a.m. by pain. So his pain is from 6 a.m. to 4 p.m. Appetite is good. There is no special desire or aversion. Some heartburn is there. Rheumatic pain in general. No special modalities are there for rheumatic pain. Weather condition do not affect him so much. Amongst the mental, he says that he is aggravated in himself if angry. Neither care nor worry. Na to kisi ki chinta karta hai, na khud chintit rehta hai. Quick tempered but controls it. Gussa jaldi aata hai lekin apne aap ko sambhalta hai, control kar leta hai. Weak concentration. On these symptoms, he was provided lycopodium 1000, 4 doses, 6 hourly. In a few days, the patient reported that he hasn't slightest effect after giving medicine, but there were additional symptoms. Pain, especially at 6 a.m., comes in waves and spasms now, has to draw up knees on abdomen, causes him to roll in discomfort. मतलब उसको डेवलप होना पड़ जाता है, बेड पे रोल करता है, इतना दर्द होता है उसको. His worse if he gets angry. उससे से उस तकलीफ बढ़ जाती है. Better by coffee. He gets cramps in arms readily when rowing. जब वो है नाव चलाता है उसका, तब उसके हाथ में क्रैम्प्स आ जाते हैं. Abdomen. The pain is aggravated 6 a.m. We have taken from Kent, page 555. Main medicines are colocynth, oxalic acid. Versus up to 4 p.m., the medicines are causticum, lycopodium. Versus by anger, the main medicines are chamomilla, colocynth, nactomica, strepsagria, and sulfur. Better by coffee, it is colocynth. So this time we have given colocynth 1 m, 4 doses, 6 hourly. After a few days, patient reported that he has been practically well since last few days. So he was provided with no medicine, only placebo. On June 3rd, again he reported and said, nothing wrong with me, no medicine was given because he was going well. Then on June 29, within another 24-25 days, the patient reported that he is not wakened at 6 a.m. due to these complaints like pain abdomen. Never feel pain at 4 p.m. now. He is sleeping perfectly, but some flatulence still occurs. There is no heartburn. Distension hardly present. Rheumatic pains are gone almost, but not quite well. still no medicine, no other medicine was prescribed except placebo. But as the patient is still complaining of indigestion, some distension, we thought that a higher potency of colocin should be prescribed. So here we have given colocin 10,000, 4 doses, 6 hour D this time. So in the next visit on June 18th, mother reports that the medicine upset him somewhat at first, but since then and now is perfectly well. So there was initial aggravation, or the homeopathic aggravation was reported. So the remarks in this case, we had here nothing but particulars to work with, but they were so definite, though not obtained till second visit. Lycopodium had 4 PM aggravation, also general aggravation after anger and the better escape letter. We thus see the great difficulty of prescribing on particulars. So we had herrings 3 lakhs to our stool, but that was not enough here. So this case was solved on the basis of hot and chilly. Lycopodium is a hot patient, whereas colocin is a chilly patient. And our patient was a little chilly one. So the thermals have solved this case very well. Thermals have proved as eliminating in this case. So after discussing this topic today, now we move on to assignment of the day. In the subject of repertory, first of all, we will put up a competitive question. The question is as follows. Which of the following is a chili medicine? Whether it is Bryonia, Lycopodium, Euphrasia, or Ammonium Carb. Which of them is a chili medicine? You have to tell. Now, in further assignment, we would like to give you a university question, rather two questions to check understanding your understanding about the topic you have studied right now. The question number one is, what various thermals does Gibson-Miller types contain? क्या क्या टाइप के थर्मल्स गिब्सन मिलर ने डिस्कस किए? Then the question number second is, what thermal type is arsenicum iodum? Ars iodum में क्या थर्मल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक हैं? ये आपको बताना है. So thank you all for keeping patience while watching this video. We will see you back again with another lecture. Till then, goodbye.